Eric Davis at Cripplegate, studying the greatest revival ever. When, where did this take place? A long time ago in a city called Nineveh, when a man rather begrudgingly went and preached a rather non-attractive message, revival broke out. Everyone got saved. What can we learn from that ancient story in our current context? At least 9 things. Here we go from Eric Davis. Number 1, the conversions numbered in the hundreds of thousands. This was massive. Why? Why did so many people get saved? Maybe we could learn something from that. Let's look at point number 2. Except for conversion, there were no signs and wonders. These days, at so many so-called revivals, a whole lot of supposed healings happen. A lot of people might be getting knocked down. None of that happened in Nineveh. What did happen in Nineveh that caused a breakout of salvations? Number 3 from Eric Davis. The preaching was not that great. His message, it wasn't all that attractive, nor frankly well delivered. Repent, or Nineveh will be destroyed in 40 days, over and over again. I don't think there were many illustrations. There were no motorcycles that were used to jump over the top of Jonah the prophet. I know they didn't have motorcycles back then, but that wasn't exactly my point. The preaching, it wasn't spectacular, and yet people got saved. Why? No signs, no wonders, nothing spectacular, but a complete breakout of salvations. It is because God caused revival. Look, if you're an eloquent preacher, good on you. But God doesn't save people because of your silver tongue. Nor does God not save people because you're not eloquent. God saves people when His word, as inarticulately as it might be delivered, is proclaimed. God uses that to save people and bring about revival. Anything we can learn from that? Let's see what else we can learn. The preacher was no one special. You can do this, Christian. Number 5, the content of the preaching, wrath and judgment. Number 6, the event did not feature a building, music, or a laser light show. Number 7, the event was not scheduled. God times revival. There was no revival prayer meeting, as important as prayer is. And finally, evidence of revival was brokenness over sin. If you and I would like to see revival, we must preach sin, righteousness, judgment. Oh, and the gospel, which is the cure for that sin problem. Not eloquent? Don't worry, you're qualified. Jonah wasn't all that eloquent, neither was Paul. He came to the Corinthians with fear, much trembling, and lack of eloquence. So if you possess those 3 qualities, then you are qualified to bring the gospel and proclaim amazing grace. And God could cause revival to break out again. Wouldn't that be sweet? Thank you for watching our daily clip. Don't know if you realize this, but because of Wretched, there are no more rising tides. The temperature is stabilized and no seals are being beaten with clubs, all thanks to us at Wretched. We sure would appreciate your support in our ongoing efforts to save small kittens. Would you please visit wretched.org? We'll keep bringing daily TV shows, daily radio programs, but we can't do it without your support. We've now opened up the website so everybody has access to all of these archives for free. But we really need your support to continue doing that. So if you love puppies, please visit wretched.org.